The beginning. What better place is it to start? When you're looking back, whether just a little chap naked on the roof with just my mum snapping some photographs, dad was selling motors at the local car dealership, my mother busy lots adjusting, using up a will to live. I was getting older, my first words spoken, yo, at 1 year old, my rent moved to Samoan. At 2:30 now we'd roll the house that was chosen, it needed renovating, most of the kitchen tiles were broken. Yo, at 4 years old I was put into a primary, I met my first friend Andrew Loftout, he was nice to me. I spent many happy days playing with my toys and break without a care in the world, you know that those were the days. My first taste of music was to join the recorder class. My mum forked out, but very soon I was bored of that. I thought maybe I'd play some football and be popular, but I was never interested, music was my formula. But so far it's laying undiscovered, until about 6 years down the line was mesmerised by drumming. Back in 1996 with all the gangster rapper gun clips, I didn't have a clue about it, I was banging drumsticks. My first drum kit was at 11 years of age, my reds put up with it because they loved to hear me play. But back in high school, man, I never ever thought I'd spit a rhyme. I was into punk, playing drums at school dinner time. I was loving life with my ear pierced four times, badges on my school bag, developing a warm mind. I joined the rock band, they were all smoking cannabis. I was only 13, thought to myself, can I handle this? This is my wait to hit the world with shows that was sold out. Back then I was satisfied with Manchester Roadhouse, saved up for some studio time and spent it perfectly. A year down the line, two members left for university, I was dead gutted, life would never be the same again. Until I went to college, met a rapper by the name of Ben, and we were 16, smoking resin at the bus stop, in between lessons listening to Scrabble, Blow It Hot. And 6 months down the line, he's kicking it with classic flow, with just a Casio and crack copies of the Acid Pro. I battered SM58, the quality was minimal, we used what was available to make our tracks original. Yeah, about a year later we were working on our first release. Way back then I didn't spit, yo, I made the beat. I wasn't confident enough, I thought my mates would take the piss. I was 17, I wrote my first verse, I'm glad I did. We needed to improve the sound of our product, so we clubbed together a couple hundred pounds from the wallet. I said to Scrabble, better get the train back, it's 10 to 5. Gotta go to work, I want to perv on the condenser mic.
Yeah. All right, yeah.
Honestly, man, you best go get the train now.
Okay, okay.
I'll mix this down for next week, yeah.
All right, yeah.
This is my
be 24, I'll be sure to